We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Finger on the pump, make the six straight jump from SoCal, Hollywood to the slums, chronic smoke, get burnt by the California sun on the west side, east coast where you at, just got to New York like a net on a jet to London, to Brazil, to Quebec, like the whole damn world took effect to FERC, tell them,
lay back, slow down, better represent when we come to your town, so lay back, slow down. What you represent when we come to your dance?
Welcome back to the Romi and Rose Show, everybody. Happy Monday.
Happy Monday.
It's a party on a Monday night.
I know. We're making it a party.
We're making it a party. It feels like a party.
We switched up from Fridays to Mondays.
Yeah, so we are back. If you guys are tuning in for the first time, welcome. We were here last year on Fridays. It was really hard for us to get here. Because we're so busy, we couldn't make it.
I have things to do.
She's so
it's
popular.
It's not all about just you.
She's so popular.
Or you. It's all about me.
So now we're back. We're doing it bi-weekly.
Bi-weekly,
just like me.
There's a whole lot of bi's going on
A lot
here.
Of bi happening in this
bipolar,
place.
Bipolar, mm-hmm. Bisexual,
bi-weekly.
So, I'm down.
Yeah, I'm totally down.
I mean, I'm
down.
Not down, but I'm
down.
Supporting you.
No, thank you. I appreciate that. All really do. So you can catch us every Monday here at LA Talk Live. Bi-weekly, 8 p.m.
Yes.
This is a one-hour show. You guys can call in. You can talk to us. We're going to have special guests coming on throughout this.
About the calling in. If you're going to call in, nothing's changed. Stop breathing. Stop being weird. Call and talk to us.
We had some really weirdos call in
they
before.
They would be like,
hi,
hey,
what are you doing?
Hi, guys.
Hi.
I'm in my bed.
No. Yeah, we don't want you.
Gave
next.
Me nightmares.
Bye.
Gave
we're
nightmares.
Not taking it. So we'll give you the number to call in. We've pulled Rose's mic away from her face because she's not screaming at you guys this time.
I have a lot of bass. No trouble.
So much bass. So much bass that last I want to call it season, but I don't even know what it was.
I mean, last year.
Last year, she was yelling at you guys.
I was pissed.
At what?
Or excited.
I think you were so happy.
A little bit of
both. So happy to be here.
Everyone loved it.
We appreciate you guys. You said come back, bring the show back. We listened.
And just to clarify, we didn't want to do this. It was the demand of all you.
So demand. So much demand.
Calling
when's the show coming back?
Text messaging me. Some of you got my number. I don't know how.
I know how. Went drunk
like
at night.
Calling me.
Pretty much all we do is talk shit about anything that's going on.
I mean, we talk
in
about
pop culture.
We talk
music.
About some current events, which is my favorite because I do. Feel like I channel Anderson Cooper.
The fact that Rose is an 80-year-old woman that knows anything going on in pop culture is still amazing
Anderson
to me.
Anderson Cooper cannot be the only silver fox.
You're it.
On TV
you're,
or the radio.
You're it.
I'm the second one.
You're it.
But moving along, we do have a special guest today.
My wife, even though she's married.
She is not your wife. She has
could
a wife.
Be my wife. She oh, could man. Be my wife. One day she'll be my wife.
We have Von Kiss in the house.
Woo!
Say hi. Don't be shy. That was a weird high. It was a little...
Say
hi. Hi.
A
little bit... Oh.
Is she not on? Can you yell?
We're going to have to fix the mic. We're going to have to improv and fix that mic. So we'll get back to Von Kiss in a second. Or supposedly your mic works now. Let's check that out.
Check it out.
See what happens when you're in live radio? Okay, we'll get
back
to that. We'll get back to that. But
yeah, she's in. She's in.
Oh, you are?
Then... Yes.
I mean, I got old ears, girl.
You turned that way down.
I got old ears.
Von Kiss, let us know what's going on with you. You were here with us last season, last year.
Last year.
You did the show with us. What's going on now?
Well, now I live in L.A. before I'm moving in San Diego.
That's right. L.A., baby.
Yeah.
How are you enjoying your move? Well, you're like a jet setter. You're always all over the country, all over somewhere, you know, spinning somewhere, doing something.
Yeah, it definitely helps to be in L.A. near LAX where
you can get on a plane and take off.
For real. A lot of traveling, for sure. A lot of production. I've been working on my own personal music to really get that going because it's my ultimate dream to be a festival DJ. So
oh, awesome.
Festival? We're going to come back to her mic so she can talk louder like you.
Oh, you see, that's
just
a problem.
Sorry,
the
it's mic, live.
The mic
it's live.
Is an issue.
It's an issue.
All right, so moving on. We're going to get back to Von Kiss in a second, who's our special guest.
I love you, Von Kiss.
But now that we break mics, because that's what we do here, somebody supposedly broke the internet last
what
week.
What was this whole thing about breaking the internet,
okay,
though? Why
so,
did it say breaking the internet?
So here's the thing. So when
badass.
I spoke to Kanye, he told me.
You didn't speak to Kanye.
That
you've never
he
spoken
was
to Kanye.
Gonna, you know, he thinks his wife is the most, the media sensation of the world. And Von Kiss, please feel free to chime in when we get your mic together, because this is music related. It's pop culture related. We all love a little bit of ass, so we can talk about this together as a group. So he felt, and he gave his wife permission.
Von Kiss is back. That was worthy.
It's all about that ass.
Okay, so what do you think about, because, you know, Kanye has, and he is a musical genius, right? Can you not agree? He does break some barriers. He's amazing.
He's been in the game as a producer.
As a producer, like, way before he started rapping. And he did a bunch of stuff for Jay. He's actually the one that I felt took Jay-Z to the next level musically.
Yeah.
With all bringing up the old
being
tracks.
Being bold. Making that statement.
I mean,
you know. Put it out there.
But what do you think about his wife? Don't hold back.
Was it classy or was it trashy?
It was attention whore status. Okay. That's honestly, in my personal opinion.
I agree.
Like, that's not...
But isn't that her job, ladies?
Yeah,
her job
ladies.
Is to stay out there, women.
Ladies, let's all get together and talk about that ass.
Isn't her job to be media relevant
all times? She has nothing else going for her but
at
to be an attention whore at this point. Really, what has she done other than be an attention whore?
But that's her job. She
but
has
she's a
nothing.
Hustler, like, for sure. Like, she has the hustle game on lock, and this
the
is
hustle's
just
real.
A golden, like, highlight of
right,
it, you know what
now,
I'm saying?
Now, here's the thing. You have to think about this. She doesn't sing.
No.
She definitely can't act, because I saw Temptation. She wasn't good.
No.
I what mean, is she, Temptation?
She watches every movie.
Yeah. She did a Tyler Perry movie where she played a secretary. She was very beautiful, but her acting skills were not up to par.
Is that ass real?
The ass is real.
It's not real.
It's real big.
No, but it's not real. That ass can't be real.
Okay, that's a whole other show.
And they lubed it up to make it look like better, because you could tell there was
this is what happened. Kanye accepts his wife as a business. She is a business, and he respects that. He decided, and he told her, put some wax on that. We need to make some money. We need to keep you relevant. That baby.
How did Paper Magazine get it?
Let me finish. That baby is getting more pictures than the mama. That's when you know it's a problem.
But that's because the mama's posting all the pictures
of the baby. The baby was outshining the mom.
Because Kim's posting them.
Everyone's posting.
I know, but Kim's
that baby is
posting.
On fire. The baby's the bomb.
She's adorable. Like crazy.
I mean, they made the most amazing baby ever, and the baby's taking the mom's fire.
Yeah, but the mom's fire is all plastic surgery. So what that baby's really going to look like? It's going to be interesting to see.
Now
what
here's
it
the
really
thing:
turns
she
out
didn't
to
break
like.
The internet though, because everybody kind of didn't care too much.
Bro, when that picture came out, I scrolled through Instagram. Every other picture was that ass. I'm like. And now it's all memes, you know.
But, I mean, but nobody, it didn't really do what everyone thought it was going
to
do.
I mean, she's not going to break
the
internet.
And she showed the choe. She showed both.
And the tits and everything.
Yes.
I'm not mad at her.
I mean, but we're talking about the ass. We're not talking about the other stuff.
She wanted to show it.
I mean, we're talking about, she broke the internet with her ass. And we're not talking about full frontal.
I know. Nobody gave a shit about anything else that was happening.
They were like,
whatever.
Let's see the ass.
That's it. But that ass is crazy.
Yeah.
The ass is
well, it was photoshopped,
thing.
Though, too. Like, there's
totally.
Her waist is
no, everything
insanely
about it.
Tiny.
Everything was
the ass was...
Kanye photoshopped it. He said, this is what I want. I'm doing... He goes, you know what? The Photoshop had the best ass in the world. My wife doesn't. And he fixed it. You know he did.
Oh, my God. Well, that ass gave birth to that cute baby.
So I need a count.
Come on.
Classy or trashy?
Yeah.
You're saying business. It's business.
Yeah, she's a hustler.
Classy or trashy?
A trashy.
I think it was classy. You go, Kim, make that $1 million. And I bet you they probably own damn Paper Magazine. I never heard of that shit.
That's what you said. How did
I
Paper Magazine?
No,
I know Paper Magazine.
My wife
huge.
Did makeup for Paper Magazine.
Oh, I thought they were fake.
No.
It's real.
I don't know.
It's Deb. Hipster or Chola.
I mean, if it's not like, you know.
I know.
El Opinion. I don't know.
Oh, my God.
Well, it's not like a grocery store magazine.
No.
Where
it's like
on
a
the,
fashion thing.
Yeah,
it's like a very high end.
It's more fashion.
It is.
Now it makes more sense to me because I was really confused.
But that's still a pretty big shot for them to get. For Paper to get that
they
kind of an image.
They must have paid some bank for that.
That's what I'm saying. They went out of their way.
But well, also, it had a lot to do with the photographer.
It was a creative thing because apparently he's like this big time.
Yeah. He did the Grace Jones pictures. Yeah.
And Grace Jones,
phenomenal.
Her pictures were really iconic. They were, you know, back in the day. You don't know who Grace Jones is.
You don't know what Paper Magazine is. I'm just thinking
I don't,
at
but
you.
I know Grace Jones.
I hate you. Let's speak about her.
Is it like a complex? I don't know.
Let's speak about the baby.
Oh,
you love
awesome.
The baby. You think the baby's the best thing. You're always showing
me
pictures of the baby.
Here's what you have. You have Kanye's music. I mean, but you know I'm a big Kanye fan, so I love him.
Yes, obviously.
It's like the baby.
Yeah.
took everything, the best from Kanye, yeah, and the best from, and it's like an ultimate baby.
Yeah,
like that baby's
like a superhero. Yeah.
The baby's, have you seen the baby dress?
I've seen the baby dress, and you've told me that this baby is apparently killing it in the baby game.
The baby's killing
it. Out of all the celeb babies, she thinks that this baby is number one.
I mean, I don't even want to discuss Blue Ivy because I love her, but okay, now. Now the Gavin Rosdale and Gwen Stefani kids are gorgeous.
Yes.
Those three little boys are hot.
Right.
This baby beats them all.
This baby beats them all. I don't know.
North is baby killer. Fashion killer baby. Cute baby killer. And that kid is probably going to write a play at 3 years old. Or like do some sort of orchestra with her daddy.
Oh my God.
She's on the next album.
No, I'll give CEO her that much.
She's writing the next album.
She's a beautiful baby. Okay, moving along
because I'm giving this baby too much press. Okay, sorry,
well,
baby.
Last year I was complaining about everybody. I did not like Kim Kardashian. I still don't like Kim Kardashian. But last year I was bitching.
Time out.
Hold up.
Something just hit me real quick.
Oh,
you remind me. You remind me of
a lesbian
Kim Kardashian.
How dare you?
Let me
explain. How dare you call
me
a lesbian?
Can you please let me explain why we're getting? There's some people out there that don't know who we are. They're tuning in.
We are on the.
She got naked on camera.
Rose and I were on the Real Hour on Showtime.
She was married for 72 days. I mean, I can go on and on.
It's true. It's true. Really, you think that's funny, huh?
I mean, I'm just saying.
You think that's funny?
I didn't know these
two
things,
marriages
so
down and a few naked photos. I don't think so.
Reality star. Reality star.
Or could be Brittany too, right? Didn't she?
Yeah.
Hey, me and Brittany shared some moments.
You guys
shared
some meds
too. That's not fair
there
to bring that up. That's not fair to bring that up. Okay.
Some alcohol, some meds.
You didn't shave your head, did you?
Yes
I did.
You did?
Yes. She shaved it out of like a moment of.
I've had my moments.
Okay. She
I'm not mad at that.
If Brittany could survive, I could survive.
Yeah, I mean, I wasn't mad at it either until I had to sit and look at a bald head for 3 months. The reflection of the lights were blinding me. I couldn't even read my script.
I'm pissed.
Okay, moving along.
To my favorite person in the world. Okay,
Marcus, you got to have my back on this one.
Please blast her music if you have it.
If you like this woman, I'm gonna jump off this building.
I didn't like her last year. I hated her because she dated a lot of people. I don't know where I had room to talk.
I already know
because
where you're going.
I date everybody.
I can't.
But I am in love with her new album, Taylor Swift. I love you. You're beautiful. You're sexy. Everything about
None
you right now, and I love
things.
Your album. I'm blasting it. I know neither of you cholas. Is
I mean, you're
to it.
White.
Of Half course, of me. We're both Garcias.
You have to blast it.
I think I mean, it's a great like, album.
Shake it up.
Oh my God, please let her finish that. Go ahead.
I just can't, I can't even start it.
No, continue.
I could barely get it out.
Please.
Now, this is what annoys me about her. I like the fact, the most interesting part of her is that she does date all these people.
I think it's great now. I love it. I'm jealous.
But you know what just kills me is when she tries, like, I know she makes fun of herself and that's like
she
whole
does.
Thing,
that's the thing. She's been really good about
be cute, make
laughing
fun of yourself.
At herself. Yeah.
But when she like performs, it, like I want to like I want to
shake that ass.
I want to make her sit down
move.
And give her a guitar.
She's not the best dancer. She does have a guitar.
Have you guys seen the meme of her playing the piano and then the Street Fighter?
No,
but
yes.
The Street Fighter is kicking her.
Kicking her face.
Because
she can't perform, so she like goes over the top, or she tries to be either
super
goofy,
sexy,
or
too,
super,
which
she
doesn't
just
work.
Can't do it all.
No, but I think the album's great. She did a great pop album.
She writes everything.
Yeah, she's a really talented girl. And she's growing up to be.
I mean, she's been writing
super
since she
beautiful.
Was like Baby North. So
yeah,
she knows what's
she's a Baby North. Yeah.
Are you kidding? Do not insult that baby by mentioning
Jesus.
That woman in her scene.
I'm just putting it out there. So if anybody enjoys Taylor Swift, so do I. Yeah.
Okay.
Can I just give a number too, by the way? If you guys want to call in for any opinions at
don't
all.
Don't breathe.
Don't breathe. Weird.
I'll hang up on you.
She will. 323-473-3100. Go ahead and call in and let us
Since
know your
we're
opinions.
Talking about tween stars, okay, like, because that's what I consider Taylor's, she's barely becoming a woman now, even though she's, like, 35.
The fact that your age, you still know who she is shocking.
I mean, she's all over the place.
Shocking.
I watch her boyfriends every 5 minutes because I like boys, you know, my little
oh, you like boys?
Boy band thing is, uh-huh, like, my uh-huh, thing. Uh-huh. Speaking of which, you got to be on my side on this one. Nick Jonas.
That's amazing that you even like
he's
this
hot.
Kid.
Come on.
He's
no,
hot.
He's,
dude.
He's made hot. A, like, a, he's totally created his own little
yeah,
lane.
But check
he
this
has done
out. So, because I love listening to boy band music, I did check out his album, and I loved it. And I love his new song, Jealous. And I love the fact that he's dating Miss Universe.
Is he?
Yes.
Cute. I didn't know that.
Which, what is
Olivia
what
Culpo.
She like?
She's super hot. She's in his video. But you know what? Here's the thing with this guy. His brothers are Debs. I mean, he was in like a big Deb band. It was like Jonas. Whoever likes him out there, I'm sorry, please. They're not new kids on the block. But they're sorry. They're cute. But one brother like got married. He's on a reality show. He's a big Deb. The other brother tries to be cute and he's not. Like Nick Jonas is like the talented one. He went on Broadway.
He dated Taylor Swift though, right? Am I
wrong?
No,
Joe Jonas. One of them
did. Okay.
Joe Jonas did.
I don't know.
And he broke up with her like on the cell phone. It's very famous.
And she wrote a song about it, right?
Yes. Yeah, she wrote like 50 songs. She's still writing. She's still writing songs about it. Nick Jonas. This is what I love about Nick Jonas. His current song is pop, and it's called Jealous, and it's cute. Yeah.
And then Tinashe did.
I was just about to say. So you get the girl from Tuan that comes on his album, and I'm like, let me check the song out. Mm-hmm. And he did a very brilliant thing that's like very Justin Timberlake-ish.
Yeah.
Not as blue-eyed soul as him. Yeah. But he still kind of broke out, and it's not so poppy. It's like soul.
I think some of these teens are doing a good transition going into their solo
careers.
But he
is so hot. Like, that this kid is like, this kid is killing it.
No, I do him. I do him for sure.
I'm not saying do him. He's just cute.
I'm just saying I do him.
He's handsome.
He's a handsome man. Yeah. I'm just trying to say. On that note, though, we need to take a break.
Thanks. I think the Jonas's want a break.
Everybody wants a break. Thank you guys for tuning in. We're going to take a break. We'll be right back.
Radio and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Neck, ears, hand, legs, eating ass. Your pussy's too good. I need to crash. Your titties, let them out. Free at last. Thank God Almighty, they free at last. We was up at the party, but we was leaving fast. Had to stop at 7-Eleven like I needed gas. I'm lying, I needed condoms. Don't look through the glass. Chasing love, all the bittersweet. I was lost. Eating Asian pussy. All I need was sweet and sour sauce. Tell your boss you need an extra hour. Off. Get your super wet after we turn the shower off.
That's all them can do. Say what? That's all them can do. We deal with action thing. That's a bad man thing. And that man do. Action thing. You're a bad man thing. Man, if you know, say disrespect, we no take. No way, Jose, try that pan February the 30th. That's right, gonna try that, no day. When we roll on, find your black, never that piece of the won't spray. Like I was sunk. When we roll on, find your black, never that piece of the won't spray. Like I was sunk. We are gonna smack on code day. Cause we beat murder charge like OJ.
That's right, I'm in it.
Shouldn't know that I'm saying.
I'm in it.
Skip me real quick, show the thing.
That right. That's right, I'm in it.
We need to find one another.
That's right, I'm in it.
Then you let me at your table.
I'm in it.
You just gonna leave.
That right.
It's just to me and you, your fingers. I'll be blown, no, grab that and set you gone.
Yeah. Shabam. In the S-S-H and a A-double-B and a B and a A can ace. Always the best.
Fly the flag.
A-sup mob.
Always.
Jump, flank the flag.
Fly the flag.
Lot of mram. People. See my name a little louder. I'll open me name, make a rip up the crowd. No day, three time for me on the crowd. Shabba. Oh man, say that little louder. I'll open me name, make a rip up the crowd. No day, three time for me on the crowd. Shabba. Hey, I'll open me name. Come to me name. Call out me name. Call out me name. Dance up until it reach all of fame. So your body want Shabba not the same. People, call out me name. Come to me name. Call out me name. Call out me name. Dance up until it reach all of fame. Anytime me spit, me spit. Flame. I mean, they need a true cold placer, to non-believer, he not believer, come code a paper, follow the
person. We are back. Welcome back. That ass.
It feels like we never left.
Oh, it always feels like magically never left. I know. I feel like
when you ride a horse or is it a bike? I don't know.
Oh my God, such a Deb.
I don't know.
Welcome back. Von Kiss was playing the music right now. She's playing the music throughout the entire show. Von Kiss.
Aww. Yeah.
Yeah.
So tell everybody where they can find you, where they can download your music, all that good stuff.
Well, I do have a website, vonkiss.com. That's VonKiss.com. And that, at the very bottom of that page, it has links to all my social media, like Twitter, Instagram, SoundCloud. But SoundCloud, there's only one Von Kiss. So
that's right.
If you just search Von Kiss, you'll find me. But my actual page is SoundCloud.com/VonKiss.
Okay, great. So everybody that wants to download her stuff, go on there. You can check it out. She's playing all this awesome music in between. Speaking of awesome music, who are you listening to right now? Like, what's your favorite artist right now?
That's kind of hard to say.
Well, because there's a lot of people. But, like, who's your, like, go-to person that you like the most and someone that's new, that's up and coming?
Oh, man. Okay,
you can say me. Don't try it.
I'd rather just say, like, there's a label I've been listening to.
Okay.
I'm really into tropical bass.
Dump Records? I'm just kidding.
Taking it back. Main Course. It's run by Astronomar, Bot, and Neoteric, which Bot is one half of the Crookers, which is like, and he used to be, he was a duo, the Crookers, and they did like, kind of like a tech house, like kind of banging stuff, like really.
Because you're diverse. You can play like a cumbia, bust out with like EDM, and then play like, you know.
Can you play
hip-hop.
Taylor Swift?
Yes.
Do not play Taylor Swift.
I have a remix, actually.
Yeah,
oh, no!
I want that.
I will shut this damn show down.
You
right
actually
now.
Might like the remix. No, thank you.
Can we end? Okay, if you guys play it at the end when I'm outside the building, I would love that. I'm
please.
Just kidding.
One
okay,
more, please.
So
okay.
We have three calls on hold right now, so we're going to chime in on some people and
if
have
if you're
them
breathing
ask
weird, we will hang up.
I mean, if you want to breathe weird to me, I might accept that, but just at
you
least
are
say a few words.
Go on. Go on.
You're on the air with Romi and Rose. Where are you calling from and what's your name? Hi.
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 Where are you calling from? What's your name?
I'm calling from Fresno, California.
What? Fresno, where's that?
I
just kidding.
I love you guys. the middle of nowhere. Tipping cows.
Oh, wow. Don't do that. That's mean. I'm part of PETA.
I'm just kidding.
But I need a
I'd like to chime in on the Taylor Swift album.
I would love for you to do that.
Hold on.
Let
me put
I kind of think it's brilliant.
Thank you.
Everyone likes
it. It is brilliant. I appreciate you. I appreciate you calling in. I appreciate your opinion.
This is how I see it. So
I want to hear
remember
this.
The movie 8 Mile?
Yes.
And at the end of the movie, Cheddar Bob tells Eminem or whatever his name is that what are you gonna tell them? They already know.
Oh, we lost her.
Do we lose her?
Oh man, I'm sad.
She's still talking?
Yeah, we can't hear her.
Aww,
oh, man,
I wanted
we lost
to hear
her.
What she was saying.
I didn't do that on purpose. Moving on.
There she is. Wait, are you there?
No.
Bye, Felicia.
That's why I don't like to.
I know.
Keep
I know.
And stuff.
They break
do
up.
Do we
want to
take
okay.
another call? We have one other call.
One more call.
Caller on the line. You're on the line with Romi and Rose. Ask Romi questions because I don't like people breathing.
Hey, can you hear me?
Yeah.
I can hear you. What's your question?
Well, who
My
are you and where are you calling
Lana.
From?
I know a girl named Romi Summer.
Wait, who is this?
My name is Danny.
Oh, my God. Hi, honey. How are you? It's a friend from high school.
Oh, did you date Romi?
She didn't just date kidding. Me. Oh, my God. Hi, honey. Thank you for calling
God.
In.
Oh, my God. I dated her best friend forever.
There you go.
They all are.
Yeah, I wanted to say hi, but just for listeners, I wanted to give a question. What is your favorite song on Taylor Swift's new album?
Is this a Taylor Swift
blank
song?
Blank Space. Blank Space. I'm obsessed. I can relate.
So you like Blank Space?
Yes.
I have it.
Oh, my God.
Vonkiss, I love you. Marry me.
Okay, we're moving
okay,
on because I can't
on.
With this
Bye,
Taylor
honey.
Swift. I can't with the phone calls.
Is
this Taylor Swift hour?
People
I'm over
agree.
It.
People agree.
I mean, she did sell like 20 million albums the first 5 minutes.
Yeah, apparently she's doing something
no,
right.
I don't know if you guys heard this, but there was no album that had gone platinum.
Thank you.
At
that fast,
on,
right?
No.
That quick.
This year.
See?
In all of 2014.
Really?
Yes.
Like, no artist album.
She almost
like,
hit the Britney Spears mark. Britney Spears.
Diamond. That's what it's called.
Is that what it,
yes.
Jesus. She
when they hit 10
it.
Million,
yeah.
that's diamond.
She is the only artist that has in 2014.
Well, then you know what it is?
Then I guess my ears.
It's all about
good.
Demographic because she's in that in between where like the moms like her, the kids like her, the tweens like her, the kids like her.
I'm
so she's like hitting
with my
everybody.
Aunt. My uncle was listening to it. He went from listening to like Led Zeppelin on the car ride to putting her in a dancing.
Okay, I think she's really the real thing. Illuminati. Sorry, Jay-Z. Okay, moving along.
Moving along to Illuminati type things. I will be with all of the lesbians around the world tomorrow night at Tegan and Sarah's concert.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. So,
yeah,
do
so
you know
excited.
Who Tegan and Sarah is?
I don't care.
Worst lesbian.
Do they rap?
Worst lesbian ever.
Do they
no,
rap?
Honestly, I don't even have one of their songs.
Yeah, how? Thank you.
I don't.
If I were to see them walking down the street, I'd give them my car to valet. I don't know who they are.
I think they're amazing. I love them. I'm excited. I mean, I'll give you
no
guys
offense.
A concert review the next time we're here because there are people out there that do like Tegan
oh,
and
no,
Sarah.
Oh, no. They have a huge,
huge
following.
Huge
yeah.
following.
I'm
excited.
I am excited for you.
I'm sorry that
wait,
this isn't a
wait, are they sisters?
Show. They're or twins.
They?
They're twins.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
I heard about that.
They're twins. Yeah. They're attractive. They have great music. They've been around forever. You guys are just, I mean, really.
I mean, the shows that I've seen this year are like Jay-Z.
In the lesbian game, you don't even know who
I was on the
Sarah
On
is.
The Run tour.
Oh,
I saw Eminem and Rihanna.
Okay.
I even saw One Direction. Don't hate. There were free tickets.
I'm hating.
They were on today's show
the
this morning.
The only show she's ever taken me to was New Kids on the Block.
You're lucky.
Oh, I
okay,
was.
Tell me about this Hollywood Film Awards, because I didn't watch
okay,
this.
I didn't watch the Hollywood Film Awards, but here's
I'm
the thing.
I'm over Johnny Depp. That's why I don't watch anything he's involved in.
The Hollywood Film Awards was apparently ran as well as this show. It was just a mess.
This show is awesome.
They had,
is pretty awesome.
Hater.
I'm just saying, you know, it's a mess. They had every celeb out for this Hollywood Film Awards thing. It was the first time they filmed it. I guess they do it every year, but
oh, so
never,
it's like a secret award.
It's like the Illuminati Awards.
But they wanted to make money, so they made it commercialized.
They made it commercial.
And
they put
thing.
It out there.
Okay.
But apparently, I was listening to all of the reviews. Everybody was like a mess. Like,
it's the first year.
J-Lo was not pronouncing shows right.
Oh, I saw the J-Lo
yeah.
thing where she talked about the dragon.
A dragon, but she said how to drain a dragon,
and she's like, "Don't drain your dragon."
And
everybody
we all
started
know
laughing.
You
and
can drain a dragon. Like it was this whole thing. But then,
but it's J-Lo. She's so perfect.
Yeah, she is perfect. she can say whatever she wants. She can drain any dragon. She
I mean,
wants.
She can drain my dragon.
But the man that I'd love to drain's dragon, Johnny Depp, he came up.
I hate him.
Oh my god,
I'm over him now.
I'll love him forever.
I don't ever want to see his face again.
I want him in and around me.
He took the only lesbian, bisexual, beautiful woman.
Wait, which who?
He did.
Ever heard?
Oh,
he took
yeah.
her.
She
he
was
did?
Actually dating someone that I knew from back in the day who
damn.
Was a photographer, a friend
ooh,
of mine, and
fancy.
They were dating, and they were. That's when she was a lesbian.
I wish I could get
Johnny
in that.
Depp walks in and just ruins everything.
Listen, I'm not mad at him.
I mean, Winona, they dated.
Winona
she disappeared.
Forever. Well, she ended up shoplifting, going crazy.
But she disappeared once Johnny Depp touched her. She disappeared.
Done.
Johnny Depp touched that French woman. She disappeared.
I don't know if he has it anymore though, because he showed up at the awards and he was apparently on drugs and he was acting as if he was like Jack Sparrow, like he was talking with that voice.
Yeah.
Oh.
He was pronouncing everything wrong.
Because he's dating a lesbian.
Is that what a lesbian
yeah,
does to a man?
He's all stressed out. He
is that
what
they
do?
My poor ex-husband.
He's like
my
stressed
God.
Out. He's probably like, oh, I need to be Jack Sparrow because that's what she fell in love with. I'm really Johnny Depp. And then
beautiful.
You know, that's what's happening.
He was a mess. Everybody was a mess. But did you see A Fault in the Stars?
Yes, I did.
That actress. That little
Shane
one.
Lee Shane Lee Woodley.
Yes. She got the best like breakthrough actress.
Worst award show ever.
Why?
Because, I mean, I don't like her.
You don't like her?
No.
She's like the new... She kind of looks like a lesbian.
I mean, she's cute.
She's cute.
And I only liked her in that George Clooney movie. But ever since that Divergent thing came out, no.
No?
You're trying to be Hunger Games. It's never going to happen. Stop making that movie.
Would you be happy if J-Law then got it?
Yes.
As breakthrough?
Because she is a true star.
She's if Rose Garcia says she's a true
she
star.
She is a true star. But the boy,
star.
The boy in Fault in Our Stars... I liked him.
I loved the movie. I cried. Apparently, the book
him.
Was amazing.
I liked
I didn't
little
read it.
The little
I
best friend.
Seen it. That I've heard really good.
It's
things.
A good movie.
Yeah, and I think it's out right now on.
It's not
box.
Very sad, even though it
not
seems
very
like
sad.
It.
I heard it.
Dude,
you have no heart.
You have no heart. The man.
I heard it was like,
of, like
so
it's
sad.
The saddest.
But
what
they're
a
like
cold-hearted
okay,
snake.
Time out. They're like happy dying kids.
They're not
like,
happy dying kids. Who's happy and dying?
That's how they were acting.
They're in
the
love.
Movie.
They're losing the one they love to death.
Yeah,
oh my
like,
god.
He's like, I'm cool. He's like, I'm cool about
it's not
dying.
Like they're like, then, this is an opportunity.
Well, that's my movie review.
That's the worst movie review. FYI, Rose does a movie okay. review every show. Wait till the end of the show. They're the worst movie review.
Now
ever.
You're telling me that. Gone Girl with Ben Affleck.
Yes.
He won an award.
Yeah, Ben
that
Affleck's
was the worst
back.
Movie this year.
Gone
I
Girl.
Heard,
no, I
it
heard
was good.
Was
I haven't
no.
seen it.
I'm sorry, it's not like a Tyler Perry movie, but it was apparently a great film.
Are you hating on my Tyler Perry
movie? I'm just hating on your choice.
Temptress or Tempest, right? Whatever
exactly.
That was.
Exactly, this one knows that movie.
Ben Affleck is aesthetically one of the actors that I love to look at because I think he's a very good looking.
You're so straight.
It takes me back to when he was with J-Lo.
Oh, you like that one.
So I think I always try to bring back in my mind that Ben Affleck.
I like
the J-Lo Ben Affleck.
When I think of him, I think of his brother, Casey.
I love anything, anything that Neil Patrick Harris is in.
I love him,
and
too.
And he's in this movie.
Okay.
And he's the best part of this
movie.
So
then it's a good movie.
The ending sucked.
Okay.
So anybody that watched this movie, you know what I'm talking about.
I still
And if
need
you haven't watched
it.
The movie yet, wait for pay-per-view.
Oh, my God.
Like, don't go to the movie theater and watch it.
You see every movie that's
Shailene
out.
So Shailene Woodley won, yes, Ben Affleck.
Yes.
Johnny Depp.
Anyways, I don't think a lot of people knew the award show was on. If they did watch it, you guys watched it. You saw what we were talking about.
It was on TV.
Exactly. It was, and everybody was there.
I never even knew this was on. And
all
I do is watch TV.
That's all you do.
That's all I do.
Yeah.
Okay, moving along. We need to catch up a little bit with you because, you know, I like to talk about love. And
can
I just finish?
Yes.
And, you know, not this show because I have to like ease into things.
Right.
It just all can't hit me at once.
No, I understand.
But you know, I give
For
love
your
advice.
Age. No, yeah, your love advice is
I give love advice.
Yeah, Rose is really good at this.
You know, that's my thing. So I want to know how you are and how your love life is and like where you're at so I can counsel you.
Yeah.
And we can have the support of the public.
No, I really appreciate that. I'm highly medicated. I'm feeling good.
That's good.
Yeah, that's great. My hair is growing back.
That has nothing to do with your love life. No, thank God the hair's growing back because that was the
worst.
Wait,
when did you shave your hair?
I shaved it about a year ago.
Oh, shit. Shit.
This is what
right
happens.
Right before my...
She shaved it, and then she doesn't let it go past this point. She just keeps doing those bang things.
The dumb and dumber look.
Yes.
Did you just call my look the dumb and dumber look?
Yes. Thank you.
No, I didn't.
That was a Freudian slip.
Oh, my God.
It's okay.
What she just said.
No, it's cool. I thought we were getting married. I was just going to talk about all my divorces. I thought
I had
a new
wife. Now I think of Jim Carrey.
Man.
No. I'm just saying.
My friends call them vagina bangs.
I mean, I just call them...
Wait, why?
I don't know. They just look like if I had bangs on my vagina, they'd be this length.
She probably does.
I have nothing down there. Google that shit.
Then you need to, like, fix that part.
Okay. I am no longer with Mr. Dusty Ray. He was here last year. You liked him?
I love Dusty.
You catching up, right?
I mean, I love Dusty. He's one of my favorite people in the world.
Yeah, he's one of mine, too, and I wish we could work, but we didn't. So I'm currently single.
Ready
this week.
Ready to mingle.
This
day,
week.
This hour.
This week.
And we're going to bring her out to Fantasy Fridays. What?
I'm going
to
take her out. We're
going
to woo!
I'm just saying.
But I mean,
I love
to get
married.
With this one, whether it's Fantasy Fridays or Funky Fridays or...
I just like
Fridays
them all.
I'm
open for men, women, everything, Von Kids.
You're just open.
I'm just real open.
Like a...
Hold your mouth.
24/7 like the Waffle House.
We're not going to talk about your love life, but eventually we're going to get into it because you do poster all over your Instagram.
I mean, I like to be very private with my life.
You're so private. Has anyone followed her on IG?
I like to keep myself very private.
Oh, okay.
And what I put on the radio this hour,
yeah,
it stays there.
I like to put my privates on the radio. I want them to stay there.
It stays there. That's just how it works. You're but speaking of love life... Miley Cyrus, I want you to tell me a little bit about what you dug up on her because she is my least favorite person in the world.
And it was not that hard because it's all over the place. But Miley Cyrus, who I don't like but I love, again, she's talented. Her album was amazing.
I think she's kind of getting better with her
look. She's talented.
Her music is awesome.
Her music's
great. I'm not going to lie.
Her new boo is pretty cute.
He's so hot.
He's hot. He's
Patrick Schwarzenegger.
It's Arnold Schwarzenegger's son.
What?
You would never think Arnold had a hot son.
No, but he does.
But this dude is like fuego.
Yeah.
He's like if Nick Jonas meshed with Justin Timberlake like that.
He's not anything like that at all.
He's not exactly at all. Like
I'm
that.
Google
he's,
this
yeah, Google.
He's so cute.
Let me get a glimpse of this warlock.
He's a movie star, or is trying to be.
He's not a movie star.
Deb, he's been like in 5 movies.
Deborah, he's a model.
He's been in
he's
movies. He
model.
Did the movie with the guy from the Wolf Boy from Twilight.
I love him.
Thank you. Well, he did a movie with him, and they were both shirtless.
Ooh, I gotta watch that movie.
Well, apparently he's just a model.
I'll just watch
Anyways,
a model. I don't care.
He does movies. He's really cute. But here's the thing. This kid comes from money, like Miley.
Yeah.
I mean, they're both very, you know, well-established financially. But he's a scholar. He's going to college. He's a model. Very cute guy. I personally think Patrick Schwarzenegger is out of her. He's out of her league. So he's too much for her.
Come again?
His father is one of the biggest action stars of our generation.
I don't think so. Miley Cyrus is
up there. I'm not done yet. Action star of our generation, achy breaky. Meh. The mom is the manager.
No.
Your mom's a Kennedy. Come on, dude.
I think that they're a perfect little match. I think they're going to last about as long as my relationship.
And then
left.
His looks are way up there, and she's just kind of making it.
She's really not that cute, but she's cute, if that makes sense.
I'm sorry.
She's like an ugly cute.
In that star world, she's a 4.5. He's like a 9.999.
You think so?
Yes.
You give him that much?
Yes.
Dang, I need to see what this guy.
This dude is like a 7. This dude is banging. No, he is so hot. He is so hot.
Well, everybody's in love right now.
I think he's cute. He's super hot. I think that Miley needs to drop a new album, make herself relevant, because this boy is going
to
find something better.
She has to be working on it. She's posting all her alien photos and everything
on
Instagram.
He's so hot.
He's cute.
And she went from that producer, Mike Will. You know she was dating Mike Will.
Oh, yeah, I heard about that.
So how do you go from Mike Will to Patrick Schwarzenegger?
Well, I thought she was going to end up with a girl, to be honest with you. But
I did too.
I thought she was going that
route. I've heard rumors about her.
I know for sure.
But you guys are a lot alike. You know how does he flip-flop every other
week? Yeah, we're just so confused. Whatever we like.
Okay, so Patrick Schwarzenegger, please, son, please run. Moving along.
Yeah, he's
moving along. We had big wedding news.
Illuminati wedding news.
Wedding news. Solange got married this weekend. I heard now, we that. Need to talk about this as a group because you are a music person.
Uh-huh. Hipster or chola?
And the thing with Solange, now here's the thing. I know she tries to be different and tries to be like
earthy.
Oh,
she's different.
She tries to be the Erykah Badu of the Knowleses. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. She tries to be very earthy and
she's
very,
got her fro.
Very hipster.
She's representing.
But, you know, and I like the photos of her and her new husband. On the bikes and trying to with the little flowers.
But why were
and
all of them standing like that in their white outfits looking like they just landed from Mars?
It looked weird.
Why?
I didn't read about this picture, but I haven't seen it.
Oh my God.
It was the weirdest photo ever. It's like the mom, Beyonce, all the girls from the wedding
it
party.
It looked like
all
a Destiny's
standing.
Child photo shoot if they were all wearing the same thing and you multiply
it.
It
looked like an opening like scene of American Horror.
Yes.
Yes.
And I believe he even had his hands like this.
No, he wasn't there. It was all the women.
No, there's one of all of them. And the husband is there doing the alumni.
I have
Illuminati.
Not seen that
who
did, yet.
Who is she with?
She married this guy named Alan Ferguson, who is a video director, which means he has no job.
Pretty much.
I'm just saying. Don't be lying. You don't have a job. You work for Solange. Solange.
Solange. How do you say it?
I don't know. How do you say this, Von Kiss?
Solange?
How do you say Solange?
Solange.
I don't know, but nobody better make fun of Baby North because this name is not the best.
Well, what's her baby's name going to be?
Well, apparently she already has a son. He's grown. She had a son from a football player a while back.
Nobody cares. Okay.
But Alan Ferguson, now here's the thing about this guy. He's very good looking.
He's all right.
I think he's cute.
You think and he everyone's
has,
cute.
He has like this beard thing going on and he's very like common. He looks like common.
Common's
like very
cute.
Hot.
Common's cute.
I think he's very cute.
Okay.
And they have this whole kind of like, you know, hippie vibe going until that weird alien picture.
Right.
I'm happy she's married because maybe she could stop kicking people.
I'm beating people up.
And beating people up.
In the elevator.
And I think the wedding was a cover up for that elevator scene.
She was like, I don't want
this,
you guys
this
to
guy
think
popped
I'm angry.
Out of nowhere.
Yeah.
I mean, I didn't even know she was dating anybody.
Absolutely.
Why wasn't he at the Met Ball with her?
Right.
Think about that. He was videoing it.
You're a jerk.
He was working there when they hooked up. But they got married. There was over 200 people there. Jay-Z and Beyonce were there, of course. Mm-hmm. And they looked beautiful in white.
Where was Kim and Kanye?
They were not invited.
I understand.
They were busy waxing, putting wax on her butt.
Absolutely.
But I love the fact that the whole entire family wore white. I thought that was beautiful.
It looked a little too stagey for me.
It looked very angelic.
It looked like a photo shoot. I mean, the entire wedding looked like
But that's
it was
the thing. Did you know that they're being featured in Vogue? That was part of it.
Well, they need money. Her husband doesn't work.
I mean,
obviously.
Well, here's the thing. Now, I have a problem, and I need Von Kiss. You're in the music industry, so you understand this. Mm-hmm. What's up with all these dudes and this beard fascination?
The big beard. The long beard.
Like, I don't mind like a dude that has a beard like Common.
We like
or like,
the, like,
or like Joe Budden.
The Brad Pitt.
Yeah.
Messy.
But like the long beard thing that these guys are doing.
Who is even doing that?
Everybody. All these like hipster dudes.
Hope
and like it's
eyes.
Like a thing now. They even have online, you can look it up, and they even have beard implants.
They do not have
I'm
beard
not lying.
Implants.
Actually, well, I don't know if you've seen America's Next Top Model.
No.
They did the beard implant thing.
No,
well,
they
didn't.
It wasn't an implant. Like a weave for the beard.
Yes.
But it was just glued on.
That's what you do in like makeup school.
No, but this beard fascination, like men are now associating.
Well, at least they're trying to be masculine
with
because
beards.
For a while there, men were so freaking feminine and they were acting so girly that it's actually nice to see them like go
I
back
mean,
to some.
Here's the thing. Some guys are metrosexual and they keep themselves clean, but
they
the majority
gay.
Of the boys, you've lived with a few of them.
I have.
They're messy guys. So
mine are always just a little too girly. So.
Okay, so here's the thing. So for me, it's like if you see that and guys eat and drink beer and all that, I'm thinking like things
that's
live
hot.
In there.
That's
oh,
hot.
That's gross.
Do you see hot. What I'm saying?
I'm not a fan of.
I want to wonder you. If something lives in there.
I want this whole entire fad and phase to yeah. go away. I think it's disgusting. And here's the thing. Some of these ugly dudes are getting it because they're covering themselves and girls are like, oh, he's got a beard and he's got muscles.
If they
when
have,
he shaves
long
that
hair
at your wedding,
beard.
Girl, you're not going to know who you're with. Like when they get married and he shaves that, she's going to not get married.
Oh,
he's
really?
Gonna, he's going to look like a culo. You know oh, what a culo
no.
is? Ask him. These guys, can I give you a perfect example of a beard unmasking?
I love your opinions on men. It kills me. You are a man.
I watch Divas on E! Entertainment because I love the wrestling girls and I love that.
I bet you do.
Then there's the guy with the beard, Daniel. He's like one of the wrestlers. Uh-huh. And I with the beard, he mm-hmm. looks. He doesn't look that great, but mm-hmm. he's okay. His wife is super hot. And he's like this wrestler and he's like very famous.
Yeah.
And I like Googled, I wonder what he looked like before the beard. Oh, put the beard back on. Yep, I wanted the beard back on.
You wanted it.
Yes.
Adam Levine did that for a minute.
But he's super hot.
He's so hot.
And you've seen him without so without
even
the beard.
Look at her. She's like, yeah. yeah.
Okay, real quick. I'm going to play a game with you guys.
Okay.
And I want you to say hot or annoying.
Okay.
Ariana Grande. Don't lie.
Hot. No.
Annoying, right?
Is I wouldn't say annoying. I just, no.
You
she
do
looks
her?
12.
No.
Yeah. I'll do a 12-year-old.
Okay. At Adam Levine to me is kind of hot annoying.
Hot annoying. He's
like
hot annoying.
Hot annoying.
I agree.
You know what I'm saying?
He's hot annoying.
He is. Justin Timberlake? Hot annoying.
He has his definite hot moments.
But not all the time.
Yeah.
He's hot annoying.
To be considered hot,
you gotta stay consistent.
You gotta kill it. Brad Pitt, hot.
Hot.
You can't even think
yeah,
about
yeah.
it.
Hot.
I saw him in that hot. War movie where he's playing like this dirty ass soldier.
World War Z? Oh,
and
no,
I was
the
like,
new one. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Fury. And I'm like, yeah. dude, you're the hottest thing ever made in the history of the world.
He's so hot.
And then I saw Shia LaBeouf next to him. You're annoying, bro. Like, I hope they blow you up.
Poor kid.
I wanted him to get blown up.
Poor kid.
But you follow what I'm saying? So there's a fine line between that superstars out there.
Rose
Listen
Garcia, hot or...
Oh, are you kidding? I'm on a whole other level.
Hot or obnoxious? Obnoxious.
I am on a whole other level.
All
so
right,
after we spoke
right.
about this beard thing, we need to take a break.
Okay.
And then when we come back, we have a lot more topics to talk about.
Don't miss Rose's movie review. It's so bad, it's
I mean,
good.
You guys...
It's so good, it's
please
bad.
Get your video cameras and tape what I'm about to say.
It's so bad.
Oh, it's on YouTube and it's on... Okay, never mind.
Okay, never mind.
But
taking a
keep
break.
Playing it over and over again.
Okay.
We'll be back.
We'll be right back. mind. She a fuck up a smile when she shake and bite. She no stay offside, just a lose her mind. A mark apprentice, we one of a kind. Every girl one climb, but the bad man mind. When you hear the beat pumping up, every girl come dance, give me something up. Baffle up, me give you the elephant. African shit, you know bum bum. Whoa, see the girl them march up. As I'm talk, new dance all the time. Pretty girl, come give me something. What's up, my big Atlantic? She want a hot boy, not a silly billy. Hey, when you hear the beat bumping, baby girl, come dance, give me something. Buffalo, me give you the elephant. African, shake on the bum bum. Whoa, see the girl, them macho. As I'm talk, new dance alter. Pretty girl, come give me something. What's up, my
baby? Welcome back, you guys.
She's killing it.
It's a party on Monday night.
I mean, come on now.
Ooh, my phone. Sorry. Speaking of phones, we've got a caller that's calling in. If you are there, please be normal. 1, 2, 3, go. Caller?
Caller, you're on the show with Romy and Rose. Where are you from and what is your name?
Bye, Felicia.
Bye, right. Felicia.
I mean, this is the deal, guys. We want to give you a shot to call in, but every time you
you ain't got
to
call me, girl.
Weird.
So. I'll keep it like my personal life. Don't call me.
Bye, Felicia. moving on. Thanksgiving is coming up. We're not going to be here for the Thanksgiving show. We're going to miss it.
We're going to miss it because we're going
to
be...
a bi-weekly show. But just to let you guys know, on the Mondays that we're not here, you will be able to see... the show or some of the best of shows from
we're
going to
be
year.
Playing some other shows yeah. And we're going to be every,
every
Monday,
Monday
at 8 p.m. but we are live every other week Monday. Follow yes. us on Twitter, follow us on Instagram so you know when we're on. Oh, we do have a caller, so look, if this caller don't... Felicia, you're on the line. Felicia,
hello.
Hi
Felicia.
Hi. Oh my god. Hi.
How excited are you right now? Don't lie.
I'm pretty fucking excited.
Hell yeah. Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from San Francisco.
What? The Bay? Yay, yay.
It's my hometown.
There you go. Von Kiss is from the Bay.
Yeah, I have a new residency out there, too.
Oh, tell us where it's at so that way we can get this girl over there.
Once a month, Wednesdays. It's called Pussy Party.
Yeah, that's my kind of party, girl.
Yeah, I'll show up at Bo in the Castro.
There you go. Nice. So you got to go see Von Kiss. So what is your question and why are you calling? Please tell me you're calling to talk to Romy.
Of course. Okay, guys.
Did you have a question for us or any comments on the show?
I basically just want to say I love you guys. And Romy, you're awesome.
What about
thank
you?
What the hell? What about
you? You've been through.
Thank you. It's been a struggle.
Chop liver. I'm just that
being out there about minority. You know, mental disabilities and stuff like that.
Oh, see, now I feel like a dick.
Thank awesome. You. Thanks, see? See, some people care about my mental disabilities.
I care about them, too.
Thank you. I appreciate that. Hella
we
crazy.
Appreciate you supporting Romy's mental disabilities. I really do appreciate the fact that you're supporting her mental disabilities.
God.
We really need her mental disabilities.
I'm on meds, okay, everybody? Shout out to all the bipolars out there.
Okay, speaking of mental disabilities, Romy's going to be celebrating Thanksgiving with her family.
With my mentally retarded
family. No, I'm not
family.
Talking about them. I'm talking about you.
Why'd you have to bring them up like that?
I mean, here's everyone's a little mental.
Okay.
At the end of the day.
My Thanksgiving is going to be pretty much with the family, and then I'm going to be heading over to your crazy-ass family.
Yeah. Because we celebrate Thanksgiving. People think we're fake friends. We're real
we're
friends.
We're real friends. No fake friends. No fake friends.
So
this
Romy,
is my family.
This is our second or third.
This she is our second.
She comes out and spends time with my family, so she's going to be out here for Thanksgiving. But we have another caller on the line. Caller, you're on the line with Romy and Rose. Hello?
I can't take these callers.
Hello?
We're done.
Right. Hello?
We're done.
So we're moving on since we have a lot to talk about.
Yes.
And we don't have a lot of time.
We don't.
And we're trying to squeeze in
all this knowledge.
A whole bunch of awesomeness in one hour. So
you're welcome.
We already know what we're doing for Thanksgiving. Nobody cares. So let's move on to the important meat and potatoes of this, which is my movie review, which is coming up soon. But because I feel like I channel Anderson Cooper and CNN.
You are the most self-proclaimed human being I know.
Can you let me win my Emmy? I am. Do you guys, Von Kiss?
Yes.
You're married. You live this life.
We're
have
married.
You ever been on a cruise?
Yes.
Okay. Do you agree with me when I say cruises are floating toilets?
I can't with... I will never go on another.
Thank you.
Okay. I did a cruise.
I almost wanted... Sorry. The Mad Decent Boat Party was like last week and I wanted to go on that.
Yeah.
Because it's just like my element, music.
I just think of caca floating.
Yeah, but there's been way too many like sicknesses and all that.
Here's the problem with the cruise. Now, recently 172 people got sick and got this virus.
What did they get sick from? Ebola?
The Center of Disease Control.
What?
Which is monitoring Ebola.
Oh.
Is having a problem with Crown Princess Cruises and their caca boats.
Caca boats?
Their boats are full of caca. Now, I'm not dissing them. This is allegedly Crown Princess Cruises. Don't try to come and sue me.
They're going to be at us. Thank you, Rose Garcia.
I took Royal Caribbean, and I've been on Carnival. I've been on Crown. I've been on all of them, and I've had a great time.
Yeah.
But, you know, you look at the, you think like, there's 300 people on a cruise, right?
Yeah.
Where do they all go to the bathroom? On the boat.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Where does the caca stay? On
the
boat.
Off the
boat. No, it stays on the boat. They don't drain it until they get to a certain point and certain times.
I thought the caca was just
so all that
right
fecal
out.
Matter is there, and then the food also the temperatures are not right. People get like sick.
I won't go on one because I'm afraid.
So
of tsunami.
My consensus out there is: if you want to party, you want to do the carnival cruises, you want to get drunk, all that alcohol in your body kills the caca.
So get wasted.
So you could do that.
Wow, right? Thank you for that advice, Rose.
But it's words to live
words
by.
Seriously. Yes. Everybody, let's give a round of applause for Rose.
While you're wasted, it's like Anderson Cooper, but he would say it very eloquently.
Thank you.
While you're wasted and you're drinking, when you're wasted and you're drinking, it's killing
miracles
all the alcohol.
Happen.
All the alcohol's killing that.
Yeah.
But you know what's confusing me now? A lot of stars are doing cruises.
Confusing?
John Mayer, he does an annual cruise for his fans.
You know what? I won't get on a boat to save my life, but I will to see John Mayer.
New Kids on the Block do a cruise for all their fans twice a year.
It is kind of weird, though, that they do that. Do you think that's a low in their career or
no,
a good
you know
thing
what?
For their career?
I did the math, and if you look on their website, it's not that I have because I didn't want to go, but if you look on their website, it costs like $1,000 for the three-day cruise.
Okay.
And there's 300 or 400 people on that cruise. That's so $300,000.
You think that? Have you done a cruise?
Like, gone on one?
Like, been paid to do a cruise.
No,
like,
no.
Would you do one?
I mean, I think it would
I mean,
be fun.
If, like, yeah, the price. I wanted to do the Mad Decent Boat Party. What it is that they had a bunch of DJs come and they would, like, play.
See, that sounds
on
like
boat,
fun.
And then they would went to an island and then they had
oh,
a party
sounds
on the
like,
island.
Now, that sounds
that
like
sounds
a real.
Like
that
fun.
Sounds
like,
fun.
That's, yeah. That's,
that sounds fun.
If you're
yeah.
on a cruise and people are doing activities.
Imagine,
and, like,
though, the kind of people you're on a cruise with for a New Kids on the Block concert one.
I pass. But when I was on the Royal Caribbean cruise, it was like young, and it was like those 3-day Mexico cruises.
Uh-huh.
So I was like, I was wasted the whole time. That's why I didn't get any infections.
The fact that you have no infections, that's a whole nother show.
I mean, it is. We'll talk about that next. Okay, so now that we're getting towards the end, I need to talk about my movie reviews.
Well, let me just say a good movie to see.
We are going to disagree.
No.
Okay,
we're
real
gonna,
quick,
yeah.
I need you to tell people your movie review, and I'm going to give my movie review on the same movie. Go ahead.
I absolutely enjoyed watching a 3-hour movie with Matthew McConaughey about freaking outer space. I thought Interstellar was amazing. I want to be a scientist. Thank you for shaking your head. I appreciate that. It made me want to go study quantum
Everyone's
physics.
Crazy.
I was attached to the film the entire time. I was on the edge of my seat. I thought it was amazing. It was a great film.
Okay, first off, the first hour was boring. I felt like I was watching his Lincoln commercial on loop over and over again, driving that damn truck through the corn. I wanted to slap him. I felt like it was a damn commercial. Is that not true?
Yes.
Right? And then when he finally gets to space, I'm all excited. And then it's like he's 20 years doing nothing.
20 years doing nothing. It was all about future time.
The
present,
best
the
part,
realms, like
spoiler,
the I mean,
spoiler alert, spoiler alert.
Okay.
The best part was Matt Damon coming out and fucking shit up and trying to kill people. Because I didn't expect Matt Damon to come out. And all of a sudden he pops out
and
he's like killing
everyone.
People.
Did you see it?
I haven't seen it yet.
You don't want to see it. It's 3 hours of your life that you'll never get back.
3 hours long?
3 hours that you'll never get back.
You know what I really want to see, but it's hard to find, is that movie with the wrestling.
Foxcatcher.
Yes.
That's my next movie review because I'm obsessed with Channing Tatum and he is amazing.
Did
I heard.
Did you see it?
No, I'm going to watch it this coming week. That's
okay,
next
good.
Week's movie review.
Do you know where it's playing? Because it's not playing in San
it's
Diego.
It's playing at independent theaters.
You
have to find it.
Do you know where it's playing?
No, it's
no,
playing like
serious.
At Arclight or
yeah,
like it's an indie movie
yeah,
because
okay.
they wanted to win an Oscar and any of those people that win the Oscars, mm-hmm. they take no money.
Mm-hmm.
They don't want to make. They don't, it's not a big budget. Like Interstellar.
Yeah.
He is not going to win an Oscar.
He's going to win something. He is That's not. Going to be. I guarantee you that movie's
he's
going to
win
up.
More
Thank
commercials
you.
Driving this cars. One. That's what he's going to win. You're... He was driving a damn truck for 2 hours.
And I was at the edge of my seat watching that truck.
I wanted
like,
him, I wanted a meteor to land on
where's
his ass.
Where's it going? When's he go to space?
No, I wanted a meteor to land on his ass.
I want him to land on your ass.
moving along to my movie review, because this is very serious business here. You're making me laugh.
Can we just do a movie?
No.
This is how the show
this
works.
Is the movie
my group. Movie review
yes, for
is
the movie review. Okay, got it.
I saw the Aaliyah movie.
Oh, you are the only one.
No. It was blowing
you and
up
Wendy
on,
Williams?
Right?
On Twitter. It was blowing up on Instagram. Now, here's my problem with this movie. It's like if they took, right? Like, we could have all been on the Aaliyah movie because nobody looked like the person they were playing. So, like, you could have been Aaliyah. I could have been R. Kelly.
You are R. Kelly.
I mean, yes. Because it's like if they, it's like if they literally, now the girl who played Aaliyah didn't bother me as much. Okay. She wasn't that bad. Everyone's giving her a hard time, but I thought she did a good job. You know what I mean? She was okay. Aaliyah was a soft-spoken, kind of chill little girl. The girl did a good job. But when you have Missy, who looked Asian and light-skinned, that's not Missy. I was so confused. When she walked onto the scene, I was thinking, like, who's that? Like, I didn't know who. I was so confused.
Why did they cast that?
I don't know. you had the guy playing R. Kelly looking like Bobby Brown. I was like, when did Bobby Brown show up?
Oh, my God. What if they cast that guy from... What's that Howard Stern show? The little guy.
Beetlejuice.
He probably
would have done a better job.
You would have been a better R. Kelly.
I was so confused with the casting. It didn't make any sense to me whatsoever. And then the outfits. You know, my girlfriend was watching this movie with me. She pointed
She's
out.
Got a girlfriend.
She pointed out that they use this white hat. So like Aaliyah was wearing this white hat. And the next scene, R. Kelly was wearing it. It's like they took this white hat. Like they didn't have money for wardrobe. But everybody wore it was just bad. And here's the thing, like, not for nothing, I think Lifetime...
They didn't have money for wardrobe.
I think Lifetime is playing a trick on us, and they're purposely doing bad biopics because we're all, like, dumbasses watching them.
No, you're the only dumbass watching them.
It
not
had
3.7
million viewers.
How is that possible?
It was the biggest trending topic on Twitter last night.
You are full of shit.
Now, moving along...
Oh, my God.
We all know Katy Perry, right? This is some DJ news. And you know Diplo, right?
Yes.
Diplo supposedly is dating Katy Perry. Now, Diplo just had a baby while dating Katy Perry because he dumped one of his chicks.
Right.
And I guess she was sperminated without him knowing.
Lucky.
And now the baby came out and it's his baby.
Okay.
So,
she doesn't care, though.
Hold on. I know Diplo personally. Like, I know his son.
Baby.
And I know his...
No, he has a new baby.
His girlfriend.
He has a new baby.
Yeah, I know. I just saw her last week.
So they're saying Katy Perry's rumored boyfriend had another baby.
Are they dating?
Okay, I haven't. Okay, I saw her at a mutual friend's birthday party, and she was pregnant, about to give. Like, she was due like the next week.
But
and
the baby has the best name ever.
Laser
Lee Lewis.
Oh,
it's
I love
the
that.
Best name ever.
I want to name my son Mars.
The baby has, and then the other baby has an even doper name.
What's the name?
Lockett.
Lockett and Laser.
Yeah. Yes.
Lockett
so
is
so cute.
So he has like dope baby names.
Dope.
They're awesome.
Okay, yeah, they're dope baby names.
So here's the question. First off, I think he's too cool to be dating Katy Perry, so give him that memo, please.
Yeah, make sure to relate
the
that to
thing
him.
Is, I don't think that's really
That's
happening.
All media crap.
Like, yeah, it's because Because
they hung out one time and they're saying that they're
dating.
Yeah,
because I know his baby's mom. And
so like, he's wiped up and that's like media stuff, whatever.
Yeah, and I just, it's so fucking rude and disrespectful.
That
when,
people say that.
Yeah, when they don't know that person personally.
See?
And it's
Here
it's,
you are
it's
doing breaking
rude.
News.
Hey!
You don't know them.
The baby was real.
Talking shit over here.
But here's the question. Now, here's the thing. Uh-huh. Now that you have DJs becoming more than just DJs, they're becoming these stars, media stars, and you're having all these, like, for example, Skrillex, you have the same thing. Like,
Von
he was
Kiss.
Dating... He was dating Ellie Goulding. They have this whole, like, thing. You have all these DJs. Calvin Harris is now, like, the model killer. He's getting all these model chicks. He's, like, the hottest DJ out there right now. And he's super hot.
Yeah,
right?
he's Scottish, which I'm half Scottish, so
there,
I'm
going to
throw that in there.
So how do you feel
that.
Being a DJ and all these DJs now are getting this notoriety that's not just DJ behind the scenes? Like, they're becoming now artists on a different
they're
level.
They're like a modern-day rock star type of something.
Like,
yeah.
They did this SNL skit. I don't know if you saw it with Andy Samberg.
Oh, my God. That is the... Wait, when will the bass drop?
Yes.
That one?
Pissed. I was crying
so laughing. It shows
how DJ followings have cult followings. They do. And people are waiting for them to drop the bass.
I'm pissed.
When he drops the bass, people start... Their heads start exploding and start going crazy.
Oh, my God. It's so funny.
It's the funniest thing.
Yeah. There's a huge movement in music and DJing right now where, like, festivals are really huge. And what I was saying earlier is, like, it's my dream to be a festival DJ, to be that Calvin Harris, to be the Diplo, to be the Skrillex.
Because they're not only DJs, they're producers, they write music, they create, like, a whole thing. Like, I didn't even know Calvin Harris sang until Josie told me, like, he sang on his songs. I didn't even know that.
Josie's her girlfriend.
Shut up. But I didn't know, like...
She's real.
I'm looking at her right now.
I didn't even know Calvin Harris even sang, like, the songs on his actual thing. Like, I didn't know that. I thought it was just like, you know? Yeah.
You don't know a lot of things, Rose.
No, but that was like impressive.
I know.
Because I didn't know that. I didn't know like he actually implemented and sang music and then he came out on an interview with this accent saying that.
Yeah, I mean, you have to create a sound and then that sound is now associated with your name and now you have a fan base from that sound and your name. And so it's like a whole package deal, you know?
But DJs aren't just about remixing stuff. Now you guys are creating your own. I mean, always have been, but now it's getting more attention. Now it's getting more attention.
Producers, for sure. Yeah.
You know what's just as amazing?
What?
That we made it through a whole show.
We did.
That we actually made it through our first show back. That's pretty impressive.
Yay!
Pretty impressive that we were able to do this. I don't know how we did it.
I was amazing.
You were so good.
I know.
You were so good.
I did my own damn show.
Everybody, we will be here every Monday, like I said. We do now have a Facebook page, The Romy and Rose Show, so
don't be calling me on that.
Follow us. I'll be handling any kind of bookings. If you want to be a guest DJ on here, if you want to bring a guest on the show.
Shout out your Twitter so everyone could follow you on Twitter and Instagram.
Follow me on Twitter at TenderRomy with two R's because I'm keeping it tender. And then on Instagram, Romy Marie Ray. That's my ex-husband's name. What? And
shout out to the divorce.
What? And then I will be able to help you guys come on the show and be a DJ like Von Kiss is with us.
And you can follow me, the more important stuff, because I'm really funny.
She's
follow
super
me.
Funny.
At Shot Caller, and on my Instagram is The Real Shot Caller, because my Shot Caller Instagram was taken by a guy with a baby.
Oh, hell.
And he wouldn't give it to me.
Hella pissed.
What a hater.
Von
he wouldn't
Kiss,
give it
what's to your
me. Twitter is @Von_Kiss, and Instagram is @VonKiss.
And anybody can go on her website, VonKiss.com, download her SoundCloud.
Yeah.
The only Von Kiss on SoundCloud.
The only Von Kiss, period.
The only Von Kiss, period.
That's right.
Romy's wife.
Don't go watch Interstellar. Do not get on a caca boat. We love you guys so much.
We do. Happy Monday, guys. I hope you
happy
guys
Monday.
Enjoyed
Thanks
the
for
show.
Tuning in.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you, Von Kiss.
Bye.
Choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk. For choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.